Good afternoon, good evening, good morning. I really don't know what I should say. We are, you know, covering one by one chapters from the sprint, and I guess we are moving ahead. And today we are back with another interesting chapter, force and pressure. I know a lot of people, a lot of you actually have been telling me in the comment section that, ma'am, please dig it. Force and pressure, ma'am, please get force and pressure. So here you go. Here you go, your requests are completed now. Force and pressure is right here. By the way, before I forget, a warm welcome to each one of you to Vedantu Young Wonders. And those of you who do not know me, hi, I'm Nabamita Bhattacharji and a master teacher right here at Vedantu, okay? So guys, today we are gonna learn force and pressure. Theek hai? Toh in this chapter, there are few things that we are going to learn, and those will be, let's take a look at it. What are we going to learn? Theek hai? So we will take a look at what is force. Sabse pehle toh, theek hai? What is force? What is force? How does force affect body? Theek hai? We will take a look at that as well. Liquid and before that, we will also take a look at contact and non-contact force, pressure, as well as does liquid and gases also exert pressure. Theek hai? So we're gonna take a look at all of these in this chapter. So let's quickly move on. What do you say? Let's quickly move on, because this chapter is a little bit long, and probably we will require a little time, okay? A little more extra time rather than the usual time. All right, so chalo, let's move on. Dekhte hain kya padhna hai hume. Okay, to kya samajhte ho? When somebody says that force, kya samajhte ho force se? Like, for example, let's say if somebody gives you a punch, what will it be? Will it be a force? Yes, that will be a force. Basically, a force is a push or a pull. Like here you can see, one of the friend has, you know, actually pushed somebody. Is that a force? Yes, that's a force. When you are pulling a door to open it, yes, that's a force. When you are pulling something to move it, yes, that is also a force, okay? So in short, in very short, we can say that a force is basically just a push or a pull. Now you might ask that, ma'am, when you're picking up a bottle, we are not pushing or pulling. Yes, you are. When you are picking up a bottle, you are actually pulling it from the ground. So basically, that's also push or pull. A tight slap on your face, that is also a push or pull, all right? That is also a push or pull. Cool, guys? So push or pull samajh aa gaya? Chalo, ab aage badhte hain. Let's move forward and let's try to understand. One second, there is a slight something. Yeah. So now let's understand. See, what can a force do? What exactly can a force do? A force can move an object from rest. Okay, let's say that there is a big box which is at rest, and I have to do what? I have to move it. So what will I do? I'm gonna either push it very hard or pull it, right? So it can move an object from rest, okay? It can change the direction of an object. Take a look at this part. What is happening? So when a batsman is actually, you know, batting, what does it do? It changes the direction of the ball, doesn't it? It changes, right? Now, talking about the third point, which says this, bring the object to rest. When a goalkeeper catches the ball in a football match, what does it do? It stops it. So the ball was moving, but the goalkeeper has applied some force and made sure that the ball has come to a rest. All right. Also, there can be a decrease or an increase in the speed of the object because of application of force. That can also happen. And now moving on, change the shape of an object. Ghar pe dekha hoga, right? When somebody is making roti, kya karte hai? Usse pehle aata ko ekdam acche se goonte hai, right? Kneading of the dough happens. So what happens there? Don't you see that you are applying force, right? You are applying force properly, like right here. And don't you change the, you know, shape of the kneading? You do change it. So a force can also change the shape of the object. Now, because of a force, it can happen that all of this might happen together, or it is quite possible that none of this will happen. For example, let's say that I have a wall behind and I'm putting as much force as I can. Okay, I'm putting as much force as I can. But do you think I'll be able to move the wall? or do you think I'll be able to change the shape of the wall, or there will be a change in increase, or you know, change in the speed of the wall? No, nothing of that sort will happen, because I am not capable of moving a wall. So it is quite possible that a force can do all of these, or it might not do any of this. All right guys, understood this much? Chalo, to aage badhte hain, and now let's watch something else. Theek hai, ab yahan pe dekho kya humne padha. See, what happens usually is when the direction of force applied changes, the impact on the object also changes. Iska matlab hai, maan lo main yahan se aise karke ek trolley leke ja rahi hu, theek hai? To us trolley pe jo prabhav pad rahi hogi na, when I'm pushing it this way, that'll be different. Whereas if I go the other way round and then I push it in a different direction, now the impact is going to be different. Iska prabhav, force ka prabhav change hota hai jab aap direction change karte ho, theek hai? Jab aap direction change karoge, force ki prabhav mein bhi change aati hai. Now moving on. So can you understand this? The forces get added up when the forces are applied in the same direction. So for example, I am pushing a big almira, okay, a big wardrobe, I'm pushing it this way. Now my my brother also comes and he also tries to help me in the same direction. Don't you think we will be easily able to move the wardrobe from one place to another, because both of us are acting in the same direction, right? Now in the next case, what happens here? The forces get subtracted or reduces when the forces are applied in the opposite direction. So what happens when the other person is, let's say that I have a simple door here, I am pushing it from this side, my brother is pushing it from the other side. Do you think we will be able to either close the door or open the door at all? No, both of us will be like standing here like, pehle tu chhod, nahi tu chhod, nahi tu chhod. We will do that, right? This is what happens. So basically when it is in the opposite direction, what happens? What happens? The forces get subtracted or reduced. But when it is in the same direction, it gets added up. Cool, clear? Ye sabko clear hua? Sabko samajh aa raha hai? Pakka? Chalo, theek hai. Ab aage badhenge. Usse pehle we are going to look at, yes, we are going to look at this, okay? So Vedantu is not only bringing you sprint for 6, 7th and 8th, but we also are getting you crash courses, okay? So right here are all the links for 6th, 7th and 8th grade. We do have crash courses. Come up, buy this. It'll be amazing to see you all in the class. All you have to do is just visit this link, http://vdnt.in/yd6cc. And what you have to do is, if you are in 7th standard, then change the yd6cc to yd7cc. And if you are in 8th standard, then likewise, change it to yt8cc. Also, you gotta use the coupon code NBCC. That is NB for my name, Nabamita. And for crash course, CC. You will get it for just 2850. So don't miss out on the opportunity. Do come. It'll be fun to see you all in the class, okay? Alright, so now let's move on again. Chalo, ab aage badhte hain, theek hai? Ab aage badhte hain, and now we're gonna understand something known as contact and non-contact force. Aap logon ko contact se to samajh aata hai, right? For example, contact means something that has to be in touch, okay? Something that has to be in touch, that is known as contact. And non-contact is jisko contact mein rehna hi nahi hai, something that doesn't have to be in touch. So there are forces which acts without any contact, dur dur se hi force ho jata hai. And there are forces jiske liye contact mein hona bahut zaruri hai, theek hai? Let's see which are the contact forces. The contact forces ka sabse bada example hai muscular force. So you guys know, you might have studied in your body movements. 6th class 6 mein pad liya hoga body movements mein ki muscular force kya hota, biceps triceps, right? Biceps triceps, don't you know that your muscles are attached to your bone and they help you to move your body, right? Aapko pata hai. So muscular force mein you can see that kya karna hai, muscular force mein contact hai, muscles ke beech mein there is contact, aur contact ke wajah se ek muscle relax karta hai, ek muscle contract karta hai, and you can move certain things like this. See, when you're trying to pick up something, of course the muscles in your body will be in contact and they will guide you, they will contract or relax based on how you want to move it, and that's how you are going to apply force on something. So now do you understand that muscular force is a contact force? So basically for muscular force to exist, the forces resulting due to action of muscles is known as muscular force. Okay, muscular force is a contact force. Now we're going to talk about another very important contact force, and that is friction. भाई साहब, फ्रिक्शन के बिना तो जिंदगी बेकार होती है ना. फ्रिक्शन तो चाहिए ही चाहिए. गाड़ी चलाते, साइकिल चलाते, कुछ भी करते हैं, फुटबॉल खेलते हैं, एवरीथिंग रिक्वायर्स फ्रिक्शन. सो डू यू सी दैट फॉर फ्रिक्शन टू हैपन, जैसे कि लेट्स से दैट इफ यू आर ड्राइविंग अ कार ऑन द रोड, द कार टायर्स हैव टू बी इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द रोड, करेक्ट? राइट, इट हैज टू बी इन कॉन्टैक्ट. सो वेन यू आर किकिंग अ फुटबॉल, व्हाट हैपन्स? द फुटबॉल हैज टू बी ऑन द ग्राउंड, बी इन टच विद द ग्राउंड, राइट? For that also. Or even if you are trying to move the football, what do you have to do? You have to touch it with your leg to move it. So there is a contact there also. So basically, frictional force, in case of frictional force, a body has to be in touch. Okay, this is a contact force. Two bodies have to be in touch with each other for frictional force to act on it. Are you clear? Are you getting it? Ki confusion hai. Agar confusion hai, toh do not forget to join the Telegram group, which I will tell you about at the end of the class. Also, don't forget to at least comment on the video right here, so that I can come. I will come there. I will explain your doubts. So don't worry about that also. Now, take a look at this right here. See, for friction kya karta hai? Friction hamesha na motion ke opposite kaam karta hai. Toh jaise agar main is side chal rahi hungi, friction will be walking against me on this side, ठीक है? वो opposite direction में काम करेगा और कोशिश करेगा कि मेरी movement जो है वो stop हो जाए. Friction का यही काम होता है. Usually friction क्या करता है? Opposite direction में काम करता है, ठीक है? Are you getting it? Clear? Okay, चलो. तो friction का भी देख लेते, पढ़ लेते यहाँ पे. The force which opposes the motion of any object, frictional force acts between the surface of the object and the ground. Clear? As I just told you, two bodies have to be in touch with each other for frictional force to work on it. ठीक है? Now moving on. Now we're going to talk about non-contact forces. So basically, these are non-contact forces. Non-contact force में हमारे पास क्या है? Gravitational force, magnetic force and electrostatic force. ठीक है? तो gravitational force बेटा आप लोग समझते ही हो, है ना? जैसे कि you all know that sun has gravity. You know, sun has gravity and it makes sure that all the planets in the solar system are revolving around it. How does it do it? Are all the planets tied by a thread or something? Are they all in touch? No. You don't see that the sun is absolutely in touch with sun, right? I mean, the earth is absolutely in touch with sun. Do you see that? No, you don't. So basically, you can see that earth is like far, far away from sun. But even then, there is a force that acts on Earth, which makes it revolve around the Sun. Or let's talk about, थोड़ा घर के पास बात करते, Moon. हमारे पास satellite है, Moon is our natural satellite, and Moon is also revolving around the Earth, right? Correct? How? Because there is a gravitational force which is guiding this revolution or the movement of planets or the natural satellites around something. Okay? And you can see that two bodies are not in contact. They do not have any contact between them. They are far, far away, and yet there is a force that is acting between them. Okay? All right. Talking about magnetic force. Let's say if I had a magnet, Do I have to go and touch something that is magnetic? I don't think so. You don't really have to do that. All you have to do is, agar aapke paas ek magnet hai, to bas aise rakh do. If the magnet is strong enough, what will happen is, if the magnet is strong enough, then what will happen? You will definitely see that the magnet is attracting all the magnetic materials to it. You don't really have to go and touch something, right? If it is magnetic, it will definitely get attracted or get repelled. मतलब दूर भाग जाएगा, right? तो magnetic force के लिए भी आपको contact की जरूरत नहीं है. And then talking about electrostatic force. कभी कभार क्या होता है? You would have combed your hair और उसके सामने क्या कर दो? छोटे-छोटे कागज के ऐसे टुकड़े करके रख दो. Don't touch the paper, but just put your comb near it. What will happen? The paper pieces will get attracted to the comb, right? Why will that happen? Because there is some charge that has accumulated on the comb, okay? And that will help the paper pieces to get attracted to the comb. And now, do you see that there was a contact between them? No. There was no contact between them. I just simply got attracted to the comb, just like how this balloon is working here. ठीक है, balloon को ऐसे थोड़ा सर पे घिसो और you know just keep it near the paper pieces. Do you see there is a contact between the paper pieces? No, there is no contact between the paper pieces and the balloon, but you can still see that the paper pieces are getting attracted to the balloon. So do you understand now that gravitational, magnetic and electrostatic are non-contact forces? Clear beta? Clear? Everybody understood this? Chalo, theek hai, aage badhte hain. So this is something that I just explained it to you already. Theek hai, gravitational force does not require any contact between the objects to act. Magnetic force also does not require any contact between the object to act. So does electrostatic force. Electrostatic force also does not require any contact between the objects to act. Alright, clear? Now, अभी हम बात करेंगे प्रेशर के बारे में. ठीक है, तो फोर्स आप लोगों ने बहुत पढ़ लिया, अभी हम बात करेंगे प्रेशर के बारे में. देखो प्रेशर क्या होता है, द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ फोर्स ऑन एनी ऑब्जेक्ट, मतलब आप कितने हाउ डू आई से इट, इंटेंसिटी एज इन स्केल, एक नंबर, कितना ज्यादा आपके पास फोर्स है. ठीक है, तो वो होती है इंटेंसिटी. जैसे अर्थक्वेक की भी बोलते हैं ना लोग कि अर्थक्वेक की इंटेंसिटी इतनी थी, दैट मींस द इफेक्ट. ओके, सो द इफेक्ट ऑफ फोर्स, ओके, विथ विच यू आर यू नो अप्लाइंग अ फोर्स, नॉट इवन इफेक्ट एक्चुअली, वेल आई डोंट नो हाउ टू पुट इट अक्रॉस, जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड. ठीक है, उसके बावजूद भी नहीं समझ आया तो डू लेट मी नो इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. सो या, द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ फोर्स ऑन एनी ऑब्जेक्ट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द एरिया ऑफ एप्लीकेशन एंड द फोर्स अप्लाइड. तो बेसिकली एंड नाउ द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ फोर्स इज नोन एज प्रेशर. तो प्रेशर क्या है, आप कितना फोर्स कितने एरिया में डाल रहे हो, दैट विल डिफाइन योर प्रेशर. क्या है प्रेशर, जैसे कि मानो आई हैव दिस स्क्रीन और यहां पे अगर भर के मान लो 10 न्यूटन. ठीक है, आई हैव लाइक 10 न्यूटन और 10 न्यूटन के जोर से इफ आई पंच इट, देन व्हाट विल इट हैपन, यू विल हैव टू कैलकुलेट द एरिया ऑन विच आई पंच्ड और मेरे पंच की इंटेंसिटी कितनी, मतलब कितने फोर्स से मैंने पंच किया. ठीक है, दैट विल गिव यू द प्रेशर. प्रेशर क्या था, तो ये ट्रायंगल देखो अच्छे से. ठीक है, टेक अ लुक एट दिस ट्रायंगल एंड यू विल बी इजीली अंडरस्टैंडिंग कि इसकी फॉर्मूला कैसे करनी चाहिए. ओके, इसकी फॉर्मूला कैसे करनी है, यू विल इजीली बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. वन सेकेंड, टेक अ लुक एट दिस. तो ये ट्रायंगल है, यहां पे इसको तीन पार्ट में डिवाइड कर दो. ठीक है, एक यहां पे लिख दो एफ, एफ आ गया, ए आ गया, पी आ गया. ए का मतलब एरिया, पी का मतलब प्रेशर और एफ इज फोर्स. तो आराम से निकाल सकते हो. अभी हमने क्या किया, प्रेशर निकालना है हमें. तो प्रेशर क्या होगा, प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाय एरिया. ठीक है, आ गया समझ. अब मानो हमें निकालना है एरिया, तो एरिया क्या होगा, फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाय प्रेशर. ठीक है, आ गया समझ. अब मानो हमें निकालना है फोर्स, फोर्स क्या है, फोर्स इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू पी, दैट इज एरिया इंटू प्रेशर. इजी है ना, एक ट्रायंगल से सारा फॉर्मूला निकल जाएगा. सो व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड, प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाय एरिया. कितने एरिया में आप कितना फोर्स डाल रहे हो, दैट विल टेल यू व्हाट इज द प्रेशर. कूल गाइज, ठीक है, चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं. अब क्या है, प्रेशर की फॉर्मूला भी बता दी. ओ बाय द वे, ओके, सॉरी, आई एम सो सॉरी टू टेल यू दैट प्रेशर को किस चीज में मेजर कर सकते हैं. यस, द यूनिट ऑफ प्रेशर, देखो यूनिट ऑफ प्रेशर इज पास्कल. ठीक है, यूनिट ऑफ प्रेशर इज पास्कल, यहां पे लिख देती हूं पास्कल. पास्कल इज द यूनिट ऑफ प्रेशर. ठीक है, ओके, ऑल राइट. सो नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन एंड लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड. अच्छा, सॉलिड में तो प्रेशर होता ही है, ये सब आप सबने देखा होगा. जैसे कि अच्छा, एक और चीज आपने देखा होगा, जब आपके घर में इफ somebody इज लेट्स से दैट यू नो यू आर ट्राइंग टू हैमर अ नेल, दीवारों पे कीले लगाते हैं ना ऐसे कुछ टांगने के लिए, तो वो कीले क्या होते, बहुत नुकीले होते, दे वेरी शार्प, राइट, दे वेरी शार्प. व्हाई आर दे शार्प, इट कुड हैव बीन ब्लंट ऑल्सो, राइट. इफ इट वॉज ब्लंट देन वॉट विल हैपन, अगर ये ब्लंट होता तो पता है क्या होता, तो इट वॉज नॉट पॉसिबल टू ईजिली पुट इट इन साइड द वॉल, क्योंकि जितना बड़ा एरिया होगा उसमें क्या होगा, फोर्स जो है, जितना फोर्स आप डालोगे वो डिवाइड हो जाएगा पूरे चीज में. बट अगर हमने बहुत छोटा सा एरिया रखा तो क्या होगा, फोर्स की इंटेंसिटी उस पर बहुत ज्यादा होगी. ठीक है, इसीलिए लेट्स से दैट यू हैव टू वॉक ऑन अ स्नो, कैन यू एक्चुअली वेयर स्टिलेटोस, बड़ा सा पेंसिल हिल पहन के आप वॉक कर सकते हो? नहीं, वहां पे टूट जाएगा क्योंकि प्रेशर की इंटेंसिटी, प्रेशर बहुत ज्यादा पड़ रहा होगा उस एरिया पे, तो वो टूट जाएगी. पर अगर आपने फैला दिया, एक वेब्ड फीट वाला अगर जूता पहना, तो क्या होगा, वहां पे प्रेशर जो है वो डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो जाएगा, मतलब हर एक पॉइंट पे कम प्रेशर पड़ेगा. तो दैट विल हेल्प यू. सो व्हाट यू अंडरस्टैंड, यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इफ एरिया इंक्रीजेस, ठीक है, इफ एरिया इंक्रीजेस क्या होता है, प्रेशर डिक्रीजेस. ठीक है, प्रेशर डिक्रीजेस और वाइस वर्सा, और अगर एरिया कम हो जाती है तो प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस. क्लियर गाइज एवरीबॉडी? चलो, तो सॉलिड का तो समझ आ गया. Exactly because of this area and pressures, you know, this thing, the inversely proportional case जो है, मतलब अगर area बढ़ती है तो pressure घटता है, pressure अगर area घटती है तो pressure बढ़ता है, right? इसी वजह से you would have seen कि आपके घर में जो चाकू होता है उसका जो you know the portion from which you cut something, that is very thin. Why? Because the pressure that the force that you are applying will be concentrated on one place and it will easily cut something. Cool? तो solids में तो pressure होता ही है, हमने ये देख लिया. Now to answer your question, liquids और gases भी pressure का देती है क्या? Do they also have pressure? Yes. Liquids do exert pressure and so does gases. ठीक है, pressure in liquids and gases are also possible, and you can see here that I have written the more the depth the more is the pressure. Matlab agar aap samundar mein ho, let's say that you are on a cruise, yeah, not cruise, let's say that you are in a submarine, pata hai na jo immerse hota hai pani ke andar, to submarine agar it is just a little bit below the surface the pressure will be less, but let's say it has gone deep down the sea, then what will happen, the pressure will increase. So basically right here what you can see is from this nozzle the pressure will be low, from this it will be all right, but right here because the depth is so much, from here the depth is so much, the pressure will be highest here. Okay, the pressure will be highest right here. Okay, are you getting my point? Are you getting it that jahan pe depth zyada hogi wahan pe pressure zyada hogi? Theek hai, ab aage badhte hain aur ab let's understand gases mein kaise hota hai pressure. देखो, गैसेज ऑल्सो डू अप्लाई प्रेशर, एंड द सेम थिंग इज एप्लीकेबल हियर एज वेल. द मोर इज द डेप्थ द मोर विल बी द प्रेशर. ओके, तो आप सबको पता है गैसेज डू अप्लाई प्रेशर. एंड नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट एयर, सो यू ऑल नो दैट अर्थ इज ब्लैंकेटेड बाय एटमोसफेयर, राइट? एटमोसफेयर इज द वन थिंग दैट इज कवरिंग द अर्थ लाइक अ ब्लैंकेट एंड मेक श्योर दैट हार्मफुल रेडिएशन फ्रॉम सन और यू नो अदर थिंग्स डू नॉट जस्ट एंटर द अर्थ जस्ट लाइक दैट. या It's basically just layers of air. So in that layers of air, can you consider that as an air column? Can you अगर हम छोटा सा एरिया ले लें तो ऊपर से नीचे तक एक वर्टिकल सेक्शन आएगा एयर का, राइट? ऊपर से नीचे एक वर्टिकल सेक्शन आएगा, उसको एयर कॉलम ले लेते हैं. तो उस एयर कॉलम में आप देखोगे कि राइट हियर जो एटमोस्फेरिक रीजन है वहां पे क्या है, प्रेशर है जीरो. ठीक है, प्रेशर है 0 PSI, that is pound square inch. Okay, pound square inch, PSI का मतलब होता है pound square inch. ये भी एक और calculation में लगता है, पर आप अभी इसमें मत जाओ. ठीक है, pound square inch इसका full form है, बस जान लो pound square inch. और जैसे ही वो नीचे आता जाएगा, आप और नीचे 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 आते रहो, तो यहां पे जब आप आओगे right here on earth, ये पूरा air column यहां पे act कर रहा होगा. मतलब राइट ऑन द लैंड द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर इज वेरी हाई ऑन अस. ठीक है, इट इज वेरी हाई ऑन अस. ऑलराइट गाइस, इज दिस क्लियर? समझ आ गया कि गैसेस और लिक्विड कैसे प्रेशर एग्जर्ट करते हैं? द मोर द डेप्थ इज द मोर इज द प्रेशर. तो सबको समझ आ गया? ये पूरा चैप्टर हमने खत्म कर दिया है आज ही, एंड नाउ वी आर गोना टॉक अबाउट हाउ यू कैन बी इन टच विद अस. सो गाइज, वी डू हैव अ टेलीग्राम ग्रुप, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू डाउनलोड इट फ्रॉम द गूगल प्ले स्टोर से. जैसे कोई सा भी दूसरा ऐप आप डाउनलोड करते हो ना, इट्स एज सिंपल एज दैट. टेलीग्राम ग्रुप डाउनलोड करो और सर्च करो t.me/vedantu junior right here. find us. And all the action is here. Basically, polls, discussions, interactions with the teachers, with the team of Vedantu Young Wonders. You can do all of this. In fact, we will provide you with some question papers also for your exam to go better. We will provide you with some assignments, and you can also talk to us about all the doubts that you have right in the Telegram group. All right, guys, so do not miss out on the opportunity. Do come and let us know what your doubts are. We will be more than happy to help you with your marks. All right, and now last but not the least, I would like to let you know that we are Vedantu Young Wonders. Please do not stop with the love. Spread the love, like, share and subscribe. Do let your parents, families, siblings, cousins, friends at your school, let everybody know that Vedantu Young Wonders exist and we are listening to all your doubts. Okay, so come up, join the courses as well. It'll be amazing to see you all in the classes as well. And yeah, that was all about today's session. So see you in the next session. Bye bye, everybody. Hope you had a fun session. Bye.